Hi, I'm John Fair from GitHub Labs. I'm very excited about 2013 being the year of 3D printing, but 3D printing virtual objects is only half the story. First, we need to convert real objects into virtual objects. I looked at all the existing 3D capture devices on the market, and because of either the complexity, the price, or the scan quality, I had to rule them all out. I decided to try Moedls after noticing how good mobile device cameras have gotten and how fast their processors are. I thought finding quality line lasers and a smoothly rotating platform would be easy. After buying numerous lower quality line lasers and plastic rotating platforms that rotated too quickly or were too shaky, I decided to custom build my hardware to give users the best quality scans. Finally, the hobbyists can get ahead. Let's take a look. This is the latest prototype of the Moedls hardware platform. It consists of a custom-built rotating platform, one or two custom laser line modules, a custom-built universal mobile device holder, and custom-built suction cup tripod mounts. The prototype seen here uses a 10-inch plastic rotating platform, metal arms on the suction cup tripod mounts, and an MDF laser enclosure. But the final version will have a custom laser enclosure, replace the metal arms and the tripod mounts with plastic to reduce weight, and replace the 10-inch plastic and MDF rotating platform with a 9-inch anodized aluminum version, since my wife told me 9 inches is enough for anyone. Let me show you how it works. After we tightened the mobile device inside the mobile device holder and launched Moedls, we set up the camera. This involves a few steps. First, we make sure our mobile device and lasers are centered on the platform and aligned vertically. This is where we input our laser angles as well. Next, we place our object to scan on the platform and lock the focus. Next, we set the exposure to make the camera let in mostly just the reflected laser light. Most times, just the mobile device's lamp will allow this, but depending on your lighting, you may need to use a flashlight to artificially lower the exposure. Optimally, you should just barely be able to see the object you're scanning when it's set up correctly. Setup is complete. Now you can record a capture. Pressing record will show a prompt to turn on the rotating platform and the laser. Once you've done so, hit OK to start capture. Capture will take about a minute, but I've sped it up for this video. When the object has gone through one complete revolution, we stop the recording and enter the name of the scan. Now when we change to the process tab, we see our new capture. I'll continue the rest of this video in the simulator so you can see things more clearly. Once we've captured a scan, we need to unarchive it so we can do frame accurate editing. This will take a minute or two, but I've sped it up for this video. Now we edit the clip so it contains exactly 360 degrees of rotation. It's easiest to do this by starting and stopping near an easily recognizable feature. We also need to adjust the brightness and contrast to filter out as much non-laser light as possible. Finally, we hit Analyze to extract the point cloud from the scan. This may take a minute or two as well, and again I've sped it up for this video. We're done. We now switch to the Models tab and select our new model. There are a number of views of the model. The first is a laser indicator view, where the model is white and it shows where the laser was hitting. You can view this in a solid view with all the points showing or with only the points in your direction showing. The next model view is a laser color view, which shows the points in the laser's color. Following that is the alternating line view, in which alternating laser scan lines are shown in different colors. You can zoom in and out of the model as well. I hope you decide to back my project. As an added incentive, every backer at the $50 or higher level gets a zombie shooter glass similar to this one, because let's face it, everyone could use a little hint.